अस्सलाम वालेकुम व रहमतुल्लाहि व बरकातुहु। होप यू पीपल आर गुड। सो चिल्ड्रन, यस्टरडे वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट एसोसिएटिव प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ मल्टीप्लिकेशन फॉर होल नंबर्स, ओके। एंड वी वेरीफाइड द होल नंबर्स आर एसोसिएटिव अंडर मल्टीप्लिकेशन एंड अंडर एडिशन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू चेक आउट वेदर द होल नंबर्स आर एसोसिएटिव और नॉट फॉर सब्ट्रैक्शन and division, okay. So first we are going to check out, first we are going to verify for the whole numbers whether they are associative or not under subtraction, okay. So our question is associative property of subtraction for whole numbers. We are going to verify for the whole numbers and the property is associative property, under which operation we are checking out subtraction. Is that clear? So here three more important things are there: which property, which operation, and for which whole numbers, okay. So associative property, that too for subtraction and for whole numbers, okay. Associative property of subtraction for whole numbers we are going to verify. So first we need to write the general form. Hopefully the general form you people have remembered. General form, in the simplest way, I have explained to you people yesterday as well. So under subtraction we need to write, and I said you that in associative property we are having three terms, whereas in case of commutative property we are having two terms. So the general terms we are taking A, B, C on both the sides, and the operation we are having subtraction. So we will write minus, okay. So A minus B minus C equals to, on the right hand side also you need to write A minus B minus C only, okay. A minus B minus C. So it will be easy to you people to remember the concept, to remember the general form of any property. So what you have to do on both the sides, that is LHS side and RHS side, you need to write this A minus B minus C, and on the right side also you need to write A minus B minus C. Then what is the difference? Yes, exactly. Yesterday I said you, we need to give the bracket to the first two terms at left hand side, and you need to give the bracket to the last two terms at right hand side. Is that clear, ma? So this is your general form. Now as soon as we have written the general form, in the two types of question they may ask based on this property, okay. First two question is definitely they will give from their side whole numbers, and they will ask you verify whether the whole numbers are associative or not under so and so operation, okay, by giving their own numbers. And sometimes they will give verify associative property of multiplication by taking your own whole numbers, okay. Only these two type of questions you may get. So when they are asking for verify associative property of multiplication, addition, subtraction, division, any operation, under any operation if they ask, and they will say you to take your own numbers, at that time what you have to do, you need to choose your own whole numbers, okay. We know very well the whole numbers. Whole numbers are nothing but the numbers which start from zero are called whole numbers. So zero to infinity we are having the numbers. So you can choose any whole number and you can verify the property. So the process will be like this. First you need to write under which operation you are doing. Then immediately after that you need to go for the general form. After writing the general form, you need to take your own whole numbers, okay. So I will take here, let A equals to 15, B equals to 10, C equals to 5, okay. Not only this 15, 10, 5, you can choose any number from 0 to infinity. Now after taking these numbers, you need to take the LHS part separately, and you need to do substitute the value. So subtraction, the LHS part and RHS part, both you need to do the separately. After that you need to check whether they are equal or not. Based on that we are going to conclude, okay. So LHS, LHS stands for left hand side. So what is the condition given? A minus B of minus C. Fine. After this you need to substitute the values. What is the value of A? Yes, exactly, it is 15. 15 minus B value you need to write, this is given, we have taken as 10. Then after that we need to close the brackets, minus sign. Then after that we need to write the value of C. What is the value of C we have taken? 5. Yes. So 15 minus 10. As I said you yesterday also, we need to go for the body mass rule. It means first we need to give the priority to the terms which are present within the bracket. So here within the bracket the terms are 15 and 10 and the operation is minus. It means we have to do the subtraction. So 15 minus 10 is nothing but we'll get 5. Okay, 5, this part we have completed. Now the next term we need to write, this is minus 5, fine. So 5 minus 5 is nothing but 0. What is this 0? Yes, this is the value of LHS. Left hand side, you got the result as 0. Now RHS side we will check out. RHS stands for right hand side. Okay ma? As soon as you are writing RHS, you need to write the condition A minus of B minus C. Now you people have written this. After this, what do you have to do? Yes, exactly. You need to substitute the values. That is, what is the value of A? A is 15 minus of B you have taken as 10 minus 5. Now, 15 minus of 10 minus 5. 10 minus 5, how much you will get? Yes, exactly. You will get it as 5. So, 15 minus 5. 15 minus 5 is nothing but 10. Okay. So, what is this 10? This is the value of RHS. Fine. Now, let's check out whether RHS and LHS both are equal or not. Okay. So, here we got the value of RHS as 10 and LHS as 0. Are they equal? Yes, exactly. They are not equal. So, what we have to say? We need to say that associative property of subtraction for whole numbers are not satisfied. Is that clear, ma? Let's listen one more time. Associative property. We are checking out for the associative property under subtraction operation and the numbers we are using whole numbers. For whole numbers we are checking out. So the general form A minus B of minus C equals to A minus of B minus C. This is LHS part and this is RHS part. Then after writing that, we need to choose our own whole numbers. After choosing our whole numbers, we need to first simplify the LHS part. The LHS part is given as A minus B of minus C. Now whatever the values we have taken here, we need to substitute these value in this condition. So A value 15 minus 10 of minus 5. So 15 minus 10 when we will subtract, at that time we will get 5. Then after that we are having minus 5. So both I have written here. One is positive, one is negative. When both are positive and negative, we need to subtract. So 5 minus 5 gives 0. This is the LHS part we have completed. Now we are moving towards the RHS part. Now we have done the simplification over here. So A minus of B minus C, 15 minus of 10 minus 5. 10 minus 5 definitely it gives 5. So again 15 minus 5, 15 minus 5 it is giving 10. So what do we have observed? If we are changing the order of subtraction, we are getting the LHS value and RHS. Both are different here. Okay. So what we have to say based on this observation, we need to say that when LHS and RHS are not equal, at that time what is happening? The whole numbers are not satisfying associativity of subtraction. Okay, whole numbers are not satisfying associativity or associative property under which operation? Under subtraction. So you need to write the final statement. LHS does not equals to, this is a symbol of does not equals to. Before we used to write equals to, this is called equals to. If you are just cutting it or striking it off, then you need to say this is does not equals to. You need to pronounce it, does not equals to. So LHS does not equals to RHS. Then final statement, therefore whole numbers are not associative. The most important word here, not associative. They are not associative under which operation? Yes, exactly, under subtraction. Fine. So we have observed here yesterday the whole numbers satisfied the property, that is associative property, under addition and under multiplication. But today when we have verified for subtraction, at that time what is happening, we observe that whole numbers are not satisfying the associative property of subtraction. Now let's move to the next concept, means next operation, that is associative property of division. Okay ma, if we will check out that, then after that our three properties will get completed. First property we have studied, closure property. Second property we have studied and we verified whether the whole numbers are commutative or not, under commutative property. Okay, then third one is your associative property. Under that we have completed three basic operations. Now we are moving towards the division. Okay, associative property of division, this is here important, which property, which operation, for which numbers you are verifying. So here we are you going to check out for associative property. This is your associative property and the operation is division, and for which whole numbers, for whole numbers we are verifying. Okay, whether whole numbers are associative or not under division. So exactly first we need to write the general form. The general form is, what is the general form? Yes, the general form is A divided by B divided by C equals to, same you need to write, A divided by B divided by C. Then we need to give the bracket to the first two terms and here to the last two terms. Okay, as soon as you have written the general form, we are moving towards taking the values. Let A equals to, B equals to and C equals to. So whatever you want, you can take 8, 6, 2. Okay, these are the whole numbers I have taken. Whatever you people want, you can take and you can verify. Okay, so let's begin with LHS part. Again, LHS stands for left hand side. Okay, so LHS you are having A divided by B, this we are dividing by C. Fine ma, so we need to substitute the values. The value of A is 8 upon 6. Fine, give the bracket to this and this we are dividing with C. What is the value of C? Exactly, it is 2. Now we need to check out whether they are getting reduced or not. Yes, they are getting. By which table? Yes, through 2 table. 2 times of 4, 2 times of 3. Now, 4 divided by 3, this we are dividing by 2. Okay, if you want, you can keep like this only, or for the simplification, I will show you. Then we are moving towards RHS part. The RHS is given as A divided by of B divided by C. This is your condition. Next, you need to substitute the values. What are the values you have taken? 8, B value 6, 2. Okay. So, 8, then you can divide this 2 ones, 2 threes. Okay, so 8 divided by 3, this is the value of RHS. If you want, you can stop here, because according to your class in third chapter you are having how to divide the fractional numbers. So at that time we are going to learn LHS. This is the value of LHS, left hand side. What is the value you people got here? Yes, 4 by 3, this 4 by 3 is divided by 2. And here RHS you are getting 8 divided by 3. Are they equal? Yes, exactly, they are not equal. Fine ma, LHS and this is your RHS. What you have observed here, LHS and RHS both are not equal. So when they are not equal, what we have to say? Yes, we have to say whole numbers are not associative under division. So today when we have check out for the subtraction and division for both the operation, we observe that the whole numbers are not satisfying this associativity. Okay, but for multiplication and multiplication and addition, the whole numbers are satisfying. Same case happened with this commutative property also. For commutative property also, we have observed that whole numbers are commutative under addition and under multiplication. Whereas in case of division and subtraction, they are not commutative. So by this, we can conclude that whole numbers are associative or they are commutative for only two operations, that is multiplication and addition. And they are not commutative, they are not associative for subtraction and division. Is that clear, ma? So write the final statement. LHS does not equals to RHS. This is the symbol. The final statement we need to write. Whole numbers are not associative. Whole numbers are not associative under which operation? Yes, they are not associative under division. Fine. So today we have completed associativity of subtraction and division. Yesterday we have completed associativity of addition and multiplication. So all the four basic operations we have covered in associative property for whole numbers, and we have observed that the whole numbers are not associative under subtraction and division, whereas whole numbers are associative under addition and multiplication. So by taking your own numbers, you keep on trying, you keep on verifying whether the whole numbers are associative or not under all these four basic operations, so that you will get confident by checking out whether the whole numbers are verifying or not. Okay, until and unless you will put it on the paper, you are not going to get the perfection. So this is mathematics, not other subjects. So for mathematics, so all the time you need to put it on paper. So don't just listen the video, you need to do the practice, you need to keep on checking, verifying, so that a confidence will get developed into you people. Okay, ma'am. So jazakallahul khair and keep on trying. Inshallah, we'll meet in the next video. Thank you.